Fashion styles. Youth fashion. Exploring the look and design of the Y2K aesthetic. Download article. See why this retro era is popular again with millennials and Gen Z. Co-authored by Jennifer Mueller, JD reviewed by Melissa Young. Last updated, the 15th of July, 2024. Fact checked. Y2K fashion and accessories. Y2K art and graphics. Y2K design. Where did the Y2K aesthetic come from? Why is it trending now? The turn of the 21st century, what a wild time for fashion and culture. Whether you're a millennial feeling nostalgic about your teenage years or a zoomer looking for retro fashion inspiration, you've come to the right place. Keep reading to learn everything you need to know about the Y2K aesthetic and how you can bring it into your life. Embodying the Y2K aesthetic. To embody the Y2K aesthetic, think tiny tops with large bottoms and clunky, platform shoes. The bolder the better when it comes to clothes and accessories. The Y2K vibe is all about over the top bling, shiny materials, bold colors, and excitement about the future and technology. It's gaudy optimism at its finest. Y2K fashion trends and pieces. Download article. 1. Matching tracksuits for full-on Y2K vibes. Choose a velour tracksuit in an eye-popping color. As casual as this look might seem, it's considered acceptable attire virtually anywhere as long as you accessorize appropriately. Dress it down with clam-toe sneakers or dress it up with strappy heels and lots of jewelry. 1. Try rolling down the waistband of your pants so that they sit low on your hips. Then complete your fit with a crop top under the jacket. 2. Over-the-top bling. Why wear one simple gold chain when you can wear five, each a slightly different length and style? This is the rhetorical question at the heart of McBling, one of the flashiest, and lovably trashiest, parts of the Y2K aesthetic. What makes this particularly Y2K is wearing a lot of jewelry with an otherwise casual fit, like a t-shirt and jeans. 2. The McBling aesthetic is kind of a thing unto itself, but it's also considered part of the Y2K aesthetic. The bling extends to clothes and other accessories as well. Rhinestones are a Y2K enthusiast's best friends. 3. Logo clothing and accessories. The whole trend toward large, excessive logos was imported from hip-hop culture and became a part of the larger Y2K aesthetic. The bigger and flashier the better, and the more the merrier, go all the way by sporting a bag, shirt, and jewelry with three or four different logos, all prominently displayed. 3. A big part of the Y2K aesthetic is embracing tackiness, so don't worry about the fact that wearing clothes emblazoned with massive logos is considered tacky. That's part of the charm. 4. Layered tank tops and shirts. In the first years of the 21st century, teens and 20-somethings had layering down to a science. Add this aspect of the Y2K aesthetic to your wardrobe by wearing two or three shirts of the same basic style. For example, you might pick a grey t-shirt and a bubblegum pink t-shirt. Roll up or tie off the shirts so you can clearly see both of them. It also helps if the shirt underneath is slightly longer than the one on top. If you're layering tank tops, it's more interesting and more of a Y2K vibe if you choose tank tops with different types of straps. Don't be afraid to wear clashing colors or patterns, or shirts of slightly different textures. part of the Y2K aesthetic is this sort of nonchalance about whether things match. 5. Midriff-bearing tops and low-rise pants. You might say the rule here is small on top, big on the bottom. Pair baggy, wide-legged, low-rise pants with a tiny top and you've instantly got the quintessential Y2K look. You'll get bonus points for a thick, chunky belt and a cropped jacket or lots of bracelets. Like many Y2K looks, this fit can take you almost anywhere if you use the right pieces and accessorize it correctly. Look back to pictures of celebs like Beyoncé in the early 2000s for inspiration. For example, you can dress it down with sneakers and a trucker cap or dress it up with heels and a silky, flowing top. 6. Clunky, thick-soled shoes. There was a lot of variety in shoes during the 2000s, but one trend that stood above the rest, no pun intended, was the thick platform soles, and they're back. Take virtually any style of shoe that you can think of, add a platform sole to it and you're talking serious Y2K vibes. Platform sneakers might just be the ultimate Y2K shoes, pair them with baggy camouflage cargo pants and a cropped tank top for a look straight out of the early aughts. 7. Faux fur and other synthetic materials. The point here is not for your fur vest to look like it came from a real animal. When was the last time you saw a turquoise fox? The point is to incorporate over-the-top fabrics and textures into everyday ensembles for a little Y2K twist. 4. For example, you might wear a bright-colored faux fur vest with a crop top, baggy cargo pants, and platform sneakers, and don't forget the bling. Latex pants and cat suits play into Y2K fashion influence from the costuming in the Matrix movies, which was perhaps the most popular film franchise of the era. 5. Y2K art and graphics. Download article. 1. Matrix-like greenwash. The greenish tint that washed over everything in the original trilogy that dominated the first decade of the 21st century changed the way other artists approached color in their work. It's also one of the quickest ways to evoke the Y2K aesthetic, since The Matrix was such a profound influence on the popular culture of that period. 6. Colors used with this effect are typically black, silver, and shades of gray. 2. Reflective surfaces. Y2K artists loved to play around with reflective surfaces to distort and emphasize reality. Graphic design of the 2000s period featured liquid chrome that washed over surfaces and reflected the world back on itself. Using reflective surfaces also allows you to play with light and color in an irreverent way that can create a really strong Y2K vibe. Combining reflective surfaces with the Matrix green tint is a really great way to invoke the early 2000s and the more futuristic aspects of the Y2K aesthetic. 3. Bold, vibrant fonts. Movie posters from the early 2000s can give you inspiration for the type of fonts that are popular with the Y2K aesthetic. Look particularly at popcorn movies, the ones with posters that were designed to appeal to the vast majority of people. For example, a lot of comedies of the Y2K era featured titles in oversized red block letters. Use a similar font to invoke a Y2K raunchy comedy vibe. 4. Incorporation of futuristic tech. Back at the turn of the 21st century, a lot of the stuff that's part of your everyday life in 2024 was still considered science fiction. But people could see it coming. around the horizon and were excited to include it in their artwork. The inclusion of tech in Y2K aesthetic is optimistic, so it shows people using tech to make their lives easier and more fun. Even though a lot of this tech, such as touch screens and holograms, isn't futuristic now, it was during the Y2K era. Placing it in the context of the Y2K aesthetic makes it seem futuristic. Try combining futuristic tech with retro tech directly from the Y2K era, such as clamshell IMAX or flip phones. Some refer to this style as Y2K futurism, a specific era of retro futurism. 5. Vintage CGI art and effects. Think about phrases that spin, GIFs, and other lo-fi effects work. If you're a millennial or older, think back to your MySpace page for inspiration. These types of effects weren't necessarily ubiquitous during the era, but they've come to represent the Y2K aesthetic in a lot of digital art. 7. After 2000, people were very optimistic and excited about the ability of tech to change the world for the better and looked at technological advancement as an overwhelmingly positive thing. Y2K design. Download article. 1. Mixed patterns and textures. Just as in fashion, Y2K design is all about layering and contrasting different patterns and textures in a really random, ostentatious way. The key is that everything looks as opulent and luxurious as possible. For example, you might have a faux fur throw with a sateen throw pillow over a tufted couch. 2. Inflatable furniture. The bright, shiny, bubbly look of inflatable furniture is just impossible to take out of the Y2K aesthetic. Try a hot pink inflatable chair over a zebra print shag carpet with a faux fur throw blanket over the chair. While inflatable furniture might not be the most durable, it is pretty inexpensive. So it's not that big of a deal to replace. 3. Shiny plastic and metal. Y2K aesthetic is very much about anything that looks bright and shiny and new. Reflective or iridescent surfaces are popular, as well as colorful acrylic and glass cut or molded into different shapes and designs. For example, you might have a metal table and shiny chairs that are each a single piece of molded plastic. Make each chair a different color to seriously channel Y2K. 4. Round or bubbly shapes. If you couldn't tell by the inflatable furniture, anything round and bubbly is totally welcome in the Y2K aesthetic. The idea here is to keep things light and fun, all curves as opposed to sharp edges and perfect corners. You can bring this aspect of the Y2K aesthetic into your room with a few colorful, shiny playroom balls scattered around. 5. Focus on comfort and utility. No stiff-backed chairs or formal dining rooms in the Y2K aesthetic. The focus here is on spaces that people actually live in and use, spaces that work well for people rather than simply looking good. A couch with strong Y2K aesthetic going for it is a place where you long to sit. 8. This focus on comfort and utility extended to fashion as well as interior design in the form of baggy cargo pants, as well as jackets and pants with detachable legs and sleeves. 9. 6. Quirky accents and details. There's no getting around it, and if you lived through the decade you know, the 2000s were a deeply weird, anything goes type of time. A huge part of Y2K aesthetic is celebrating that weirdness with unexpected art and objects in odd and random places. For example, you might have a collection of vintage toys from the early 2000s. that you just display haphazardly around the room to bring a little Y2K aesthetic to the place. Where did the Y2K aesthetic come from? Download article. 1. The Y2K aesthetic is based on early 2000s fashion and design trends. In a lot of ways, the Y2K aesthetic trend of the 2020s bears only a passing resemblance to the trends people actually embraced in the 2000s. But that's to be expected when those trends are filtered through time and memory, then reinterpreted by a younger generation that likely wasn't even around when these trends caught on the first time. 10. While Y2K aesthetic definitely has its origins in trends that were popular during the 2000s, a lot of those things have been refined or switched up a bit to reflect various cultural changes in the past 20 years. The name Y2K is the shorthand term for a potential, and much feared, computer glitch that could have caused major problems and disruptions in many technical systems because of the numerical switch from years starting with 19 to years starting with 20. Thankfully, the glitch was neutralized prior to the turn of the century. Why is the Y2K aesthetic trending now? Download article. 1. Millennial nostalgia caused Y2K aesthetic resurgence. As millennials start to enter middle age, they are also starting to look back at the trends of their youth with a certain fondness. You typically only gain this fondness after you're a couple of decades removed. 11. The nostalgia gets even stronger if you're starting to think that continuing to keep up with current trends is just exhausting. At some point, adult responsibilities start creeping in and you might realize that you just aren't on the cutting edge like you used to be. Millennial groups and hashtags on social media capitalized on this Y2K nostalgia, highlighting various aspects of the emerging Y2K aesthetic. 2. Generation Z helped the Y2K resurgence gain traction on TikTok. Eventually, all of this Y2K talk migrated to TikTok, Gen Z's social network of choice. Many Zoomer influencers became enamored with Y2K aesthetic and the rest, as they say, is history. Once Zoomers started putting their own spin on Y2K fashion and design, you knew it was destined to become the next big thing. 12. The participation of the younger generation is necessary for a retro comeback to have any real impact on the current culture. Otherwise, it would just be a nostalgic thing for those who lived through that era. Expert Q&A. Ask a question. Submit tips. Submit a tip. All tip submissions are carefully reviewed before being published. Fashion styles. Youth fashion. Exploring the look and design of the Y2K aesthetic. Download article. See why this retro era is popular again with millennials and Gen Z. Co-authored by Jennifer Mueller, JD reviewed by Melissa Young. Last updated, the 15th of July, 2024. Fact checked. Y2K fashion and accessories. Y2K art and graphics. Y2K design. Where did the Y2K aesthetic come from? Why is it trending now? The turn of the 21st century, what a wild time for fashion and culture. Whether you're a millennial feeling nostalgic about your teenage years or a Zoomer looking for retro fashion inspiration, you've come to the right place. Keep reading to learn everything you need to know about the Y2K aesthetic and how you can bring it into your life. Embodying the Y2K aesthetic. To embody the Y2K aesthetic, think tiny tops with large bottoms and clunky, platform shoes. The bolder the better when it comes to clothes and accessories, the Y2K vibe is all about over the top bling, shiny materials, bold colors, and excitement about the future and technology. It's gaudy optimism at its finest. Y2K fashion trends and pieces. Download article. 1. Matching tracksuits for full-on Y2K vibes. Choose a velour tracksuit in an eye-popping color. As casual as this look might seem, it's considered acceptable attire virtually anywhere as long as you accessorize appropriately. Dress it down with clam-toe sneakers or dress it up with strappy heels and lots of jewelry. 1. Try rolling down the waistband of your pants so that they sit low on your hips. Then complete your fit with a crop top under the jacket. 2. Over-the-top bling. Why wear one simple gold chain when you can wear 5, each a slightly different length and style? This is the rhetorical question at the heart of McBling, one of the flashiest, and lovably trashiest, parts of the Y2K aesthetic. What makes this particularly Y2K is wearing a lot of jewelry with an otherwise casual fit, like a t-shirt and jeans. 2. The McBling aesthetic is kind of a thing unto itself, but it's also considered part of the Y2K aesthetic. The bling extends to clothes and other accessories as well. Rhinestones are a Y2K enthusiast's best friends. 3. Logo clothing and accessories. The whole trend toward large, excessive logos was imported from hip-hop culture and became a part of the larger Y2K aesthetic. The bigger and flashier the better, and the more the merrier, go all the way by sporting a bag, shirt, and jewelry with 3 or 4 different logos, all prominently displayed. 3. A big part of the Y2K aesthetic is embracing tackiness, so don't worry about the fact that wearing clothes emblazoned with massive logos is considered tacky. That's part of the charm. 4. Layered tank tops and shirts. In the first years of the 21st century, teens and 20-somethings had layering down to a science. Add this aspect of the Y2K aesthetic to your wardrobe by wearing 2 or 3 shirts of the same basic style. For example, you might pick a grey t-shirt and a bubblegum pink t-shirt. Roll up or tie off the shirts so you can clearly see both of them. It also helps if the shirt underneath is slightly longer than the one on top. If you're layering tank tops, it's more interesting and more of a Y2K vibe if you choose tank tops with different types of straps. Don't be afraid to wear clashing colors or patterns, or shirts of slightly different textures. Part of the Y2K aesthetic is this sort of nonchalance about whether things match. 5. Midriff-bearing tops and low-rise pants. You might say the rule here is small on top, big on the bottom. Pair baggy, wide-legged, low-rise pants with a tiny top and you've instantly got the quintessential Y2K look. You'll get bonus points for a thick, chunky belt and a cropped jacket or lots of bracelets. Like many Y2K looks, this fit can take you almost anywhere if you use the right pieces and accessorize it correctly. Look back to pictures of celebs like Beyoncé in the early 2000s for inspiration. For example, you can dress it down with sneakers and a trucker cap or dress it up with heels and a silky, flowing top. 6. Clunky, thick-soled shoes. There was a lot of variety in shoes during the 2000s, but one trend that stood above the rest, no pun intended, was the thick platform soles, and they're back. Take virtually any style of shoe that you can think of, add a platform sole to it and you're talking. Serious Y2K vibes. Platform sneakers might just be the ultimate Y2K shoes, pair them with baggy camouflage cargo pants and a cropped tank top for a look straight out of the early aughts. 7. Faux fur and other synthetic materials. The point here is not for your fur vest to look like it came from a real animal. When was the last time you saw a turquoise fox? The point is to incorporate over-the-top fabrics and textures into everyday ensembles for a little Y2K twist. 4. For example, you might wear a bright-colored faux fur vest with a crop top, baggy cargo pants, and platform sneakers, and don't forget the bling. Latex pants and cat suits play into Y2K fashion influence from the costuming in the Matrix movies, which was perhaps the most popular film franchise of the era. 5. Y2K art and graphics. Download article. 1. Matrix-like greenwash. The greenish tint that washed over everything in the original trilogy that dominated the first decade of the 21st century changed the way other artists approached color in their work. It's also one of the quickest ways to evoke the Y2K aesthetic, since The Matrix was such a profound influence on the popular culture of that period. 6. Colors used with this effect are typically black, silver, and shades of gray. 2. Reflective surfaces. Y2K artists loved to play around with reflective surfaces to distort and emphasize reality. Graphic design of the 2000s period featured liquid chrome that washed over surfaces and reflected the world back on itself. Using reflective surfaces also allows you to play with light and color in an irreverent way that can create a really strong Y2K vibe. Combining reflective surfaces with the Matrix green tint is a really great way to invoke the early 2000s and the more futuristic aspects of the Y2K aesthetic. 3. Bold, vibrant fonts. Movie posters from the early 2000s can give you inspiration for the type of fonts that are popular with the Y2K aesthetic. Look particularly at popcorn movies, the ones with posters that were designed to appeal to the vast majority of people. For example, a lot of comedies of the Y2K era featured titles in oversized red block letters. Use a similar font to invoke a Y2K raunchy comedy vibe. 4. Incorporation of futuristic tech. Back at the turn of the 21st century, a lot of the stuff that's part of your everyday life in 2024 was still considered science fiction. But people could see it coming around the horizon and were excited to include it in their artwork. The inclusion of tech in Y2K aesthetic is optimistic, so it shows people using tech to make their lives easier and more fun. Even though a lot of this tech, such as touch screens and holograms, isn't futuristic now, it was during the Y2K era. Placing it in the context of the Y2K aesthetic makes it seem futuristic. Try combining futuristic tech with retro tech directly from the Y2K era, such as clamshell IMAX or flip phones. Some refer to this style as Y2K futurism, a specific era of retro futurism. 5. Vintage CGI art and effects. Think about phrases that spin, GIFs, and other lo-fi effects work. If you're a millennial or older, think back to your MySpace page for inspiration. These types of effects weren't necessarily ubiquitous during the era, but they've come to represent the Y2K Aesthetic in a lot of digital art. 7. After 2000, people were very optimistic and excited about the ability of tech to change the world for the better and looked at technological advancement as an overwhelmingly positive thing. Y2K design. Download article. 1. Mixed patterns and textures. Just as in fashion, Y2K design is all about layering and contrasting different patterns and textures in a really random, ostentatious way. The key is that everything looks as opulent and luxurious as possible. For example, you might have a faux fur throw with a sateen throw pillow over a tufted couch. 2. Inflatable furniture. The bright, shiny, bubbly look of inflatable furniture is just impossible to take out of the Y2K aesthetic. Try a hot pink inflatable chair over a zebra print shag carpet with a faux fur throw blanket over the chair. While inflatable furniture might not be the most durable, it is pretty inexpensive. So it's not that big of a deal to replace. 3. Shiny plastic and metal. Y2K aesthetic is very much about anything that looks bright and shiny and new. Reflective or iridescent surfaces are popular, as well as colorful acrylic and glass cut or mold into different shapes and designs. For example, you might have a metal table and shiny chairs that are each a single piece of mold plastic. Make each chair a different color to seriously channel Y2K. 4. Round or bubbly shapes. If you couldn't tell by the inflatable furniture, anything round and bubbly is totally welcome in the Y2K aesthetic. The idea here is to keep things light and fun, all curves as opposed to sharp edges and perfect corners. You can bring this aspect of the Y2K aesthetic into your room with a few colorful, shiny playroom balls scattered around. 5. Focus on comfort and utility. No stiff-backed chairs or formal dining rooms in the Y2K aesthetic. The focus here is on spaces that people actually live in and use, spaces that work well for people rather than simply looking good. A couch with strong Y2K aesthetic going for it is a place where you long to sit. 8. This focus on comfort and utility extended to fashion as well as interior design in the form of baggy cargo pants, as well as jackets and pants with detachable legs and sleeves. 9. 6. Quirky accents and details. There's no getting around it, and if you lived through the decade you know, the 2000s were a deeply weird, anything goes type of time. A huge part of Y2K aesthetic is celebrating that weirdness with unexpected art and objects in odd and random places. For example, you might have a collection of vintage toys from the early 2000s that you just display haphazardly around the room to bring a little Y2K aesthetic to the place. Where did the Y2K aesthetic come from? Download article. 1. The Y2K aesthetic is based on early 2000s fashion and design trends. In a lot of ways, the Y2K aesthetic trend of the 2020s bears only a passing resemblance to the trends people actually embraced in the 2000s. But that's to be expected when those trends are filtered through time and memory, then reinterpreted by a younger generation that likely wasn't even around when these trends caught on the first time. 10. While Y2K aesthetic definitely has its origins in trends that were popular during the 2000s, a lot of those things have been refined or switched up a bit to reflect various cultural changes in the past 20 years. The name Y2K is the shorthand term for a potential, and much feared, computer glitch that could have caused major problems and disruptions in many technical systems because of the numerical switch from years starting with 19 to years starting with 20. Thankfully, the glitch was neutralized prior to the turn of the century. Why is the Y2K aesthetic trending now? Download article. 1. Millennial nostalgia caused Y2K aesthetic resurgence. As millennials start to enter middle age, they are also starting to look back at the trends of their youth with a certain fondness. You typically only gain this fondness after you're a couple of decades removed. 11. The nostalgia gets even stronger if you're starting to think that continuing to keep up with current trends is just exhausting. At some point, adult responsibilities start creeping in and you might realize that you just aren't on the cutting edge like you used to be. Millennial groups and hashtags on social media capitalized on this Y2K nostalgia, highlighting various aspects of the emerging Y2K aesthetic. 2. Generation Z helped the Y2K resurgence gain traction on TikTok. Eventually, all of this Y2K talk migrated to TikTok, Gen Z's social network of choice. Many Zoomer influencers became enamored with Y2K aesthetic and the rest, as they say, is history. Once Zoomers started putting their own spin on Y2K fashion and design, you knew it was destined to become the next big thing. 12. The participation of the younger generation is necessary for a retro comeback to have any real impact on the current culture. Otherwise, it would just be a nostalgic thing for those who lived through that era. Expert Q&A. Ask a question. Submit tips. Submit a tip. All tip submissions are carefully reviewed before being published. How to figure out if you're reading our generated content. Download article. What to look for in AI writing and the best tools to find it. Written by Travis Boyles. Last updated, the 15th of July, 2024. Fact checked. Our generated text has become a valuable tool to some, as well as bane to others. AI chatbots, such as ChatGPT, can produce writing that appears to be human-like on the surface. For those who work in education or content creation, detecting AI writing can be a real challenge. Luckily, there are some subtle ways to detect if writing is from a person or a machine. This Wikihow article teaches you how to detect AI writing. How to detect AI writing. There are many online tools you can use to detect AI writing. You should also check to see if the writing sounds too monotonous and unemotional. AI writing may contain a lot of repeating words and phrases. It may also contain information that is incorrect or details that are vague and unimportant. 1. It gets flagged by AI detection tools. Download article. 1. Check the writing with a tool. There are plenty of AI detection tools online that you can use to detect if writing is AI generated. However, AI detection tools do have their limitations and should not be relied upon solely. You should use multiple tools in conjunction with other verification methods. If possible, compare the writing with the student's or author's previous writing to see if there are any differences. Some AI detection tools include the following. 1. 2. Turn it in. AI detector. AI text classifier. AI checker. GPT-0. Copy leaks. 2. AI chatbots recognize it as AI generated. Download article. 1. Use a chatbot to detect AI writing. In addition to using one of the many AI detection tools online, you can also use AI itself to detect AI. For example, you could go to the ChatGPT website and use the prompt, "Did you write this?" Then upload or copy and paste the text. It will tell you if the text was written in ChatGPT or not. 3. It didn't take long to finish. Download article. 1. Consider if it was completed in a realistic amount of time. AI can produce paragraphs of writing in a matter of seconds. If an assignment is turned in way earlier than expected, that could be a red flag. 4. It is too perfect. Download article. 1. The spelling, punctuation, and grammar may be abnormally correct. Most students are not expert writers. Even professional writers can have an occasional typo. If the writing is abnormally perfect, especially compared to their previous writing, this could be a red flag that the writing was AI-generated. 5. A lot of reliance on lists and bullet points. Download article. 1. AI frequently uses lists and bullet points to organize information. Students and new writers often struggle with how to organize information and may not write in this format. If you see a lot of bullet points and lists when it seems like most people wouldn't write this way, it could be AI generated. 4. 6. It's monotonous and lacks emotion. Download article. 1. You might notice there is no human voice in the writing. If the writing doesn't use any informal words or phrases, or slang terms, this could be a sign that it was written in AI. AI writing will typically have an unemotional, robotic tone. It lacks personal experience and reflection. If the author doesn't express any strong emotions or strong opinions, this could be another red flag. 5. 7. It's got incorrect facts. Download article. 1. Fact check against reputable sources. AI generates text by placing words together in a way that aligns with common patterns in the text it was trained on. It doesn't actually know anything. Furthermore, many AI chatbots are trained on outdated information. If the information is incorrect or cites made-up sources, it could be generated by AI. 6. 8. The writing is formulaic and predictable. Download article. 1. Look for an excessive amount of commonly used words and phrases. AI works by piecing together commonly used words and phrases from other sources. As a result, it tends to produce a large number of repeated words and phrases that a person wouldn't use in real life. It also uses a formulaic sentence structure, such as paragraphs that start with a strong opening sentence and end with a summary sentence. To see a comprehensive list of commonly used words and phrases that AI uses, check out this subreddit. 9. It has a lot of vague or unimportant details. Download article. 1. AI writing contains a lot of filler. For example, if you are reading a product review and it includes a lot of detailed descriptions about things most people wouldn't find important, it could be written by AI. Likewise, if you are reading an article you found on Google and the information doesn't satisfy your search intent, it could be written by AI. 10. The narrative is incoherent. Download article. 1. Look for storytelling that is choppy and inconsistent. AI struggles with coherent storytelling. It may contain events that don't naturally flow together. It may also contain social cues and cultural nuances that feel unnatural, or historical contexts that are inconsistent or factually incorrect. 11. It didn't understand the assignment. Download article. 1. AI may not follow guidelines or the correct format. If the assignment was to write an article in a specific format, and the writing deviates too much from that format, it could be written by AI. If a student is instructed to cite a specific data source and writing gets its source from somewhere else, that could be a sign of AI writing. Expert Q&A. Ask a question. Submit. Youth. Youth culture. Everything you need to know about vanilla girls, and why they're kind of controversial. Download article. Learn about vanilla girl fashion, makeup, and controversy. Co-authored by Raven Manyard, BA reviewed by Anyala Gilmore-Jones. Last updated, the 22nd of July, 2024. Fact checked. What is a vanilla girl? History of the vanilla girl aesthetic. Controversies. How to be a vanilla girl. Similar aesthetics. Video. Tips. If you've been on TikTok, you might have seen or heard the phrase vanilla girl and wondered what it means. The vanilla girl aesthetic is one of the many fashion microtrends popularized by social media. It focuses on timeless fashion, neutral and pastel colors, natural makeup, and living a simple, classic lifestyle. In this article, we'll teach you everything you need to know about the vanilla girl aesthetic, including what it is, how to be a vanilla girl, the history of the trend, and its controversies. Plus, learn about similar fashion aesthetics. Vanilla girl aesthetic, quick overview. The vanilla girl aesthetic is a TikTok microtrend based on neutral tones, classic fashion, and natural makeup. The name is inspired by vanilla being the classic ice cream flavor, and those who participate in the trend often embrace a simple, down-to-earth lifestyle. It is similar to the clean girl aesthetic. What is a vanilla girl? Download article. 1. Vanilla girl is an aesthetic based on simplicity and femininity. The term vanilla girl comes from the idea of embracing a simple, basic lifestyle that's grounded in classic tastes. The aesthetic emphasizes a down-to-earth, nostalgic image. Vanilla girls often embrace timeless fashion, neutral colors, and natural makeup. 1. Like many modern fashion and beauty aesthetics, vanilla girl was popularized on social media sites like TikTok and Instagram. History of the vanilla girl aesthetic. Download article. 1. The aesthetic gained popularity on social media in the early 2020s. While the exact origins of the trend are hard to pinpoint, the vanilla girl aesthetic likely emerged in the mid to late 2010s, but only began to gain significant traction in the early 2020s with the rise of TikTok. In recent years, TikTok has given rise to many popular fashion and makeup trends. 2. The vanilla girl hashtag currently has 133.7k posts with more than 650 million views on TikTok. 2. It may have been inspired by the clean girl aesthetic. Many fashion trends are inspired by similar aesthetics, and the vanilla girl trend is no different. This look often takes inspiration from the clean girl aesthetic, a trend that focuses on natural makeup, clear skin, and well-fitted neutral clothing. 3. Celebrities and influencers helped popularize the look. Social media influencers and celebrities played a large role in the rise of the vanilla girl aesthetic, as they posted visually appealing content that resonated with young people, particularly Gen Z girls, who were looking for a relaxed, natural style. 4. A few celebrities and influencers who have been associated with or worn elements of the aesthetic include Emma Chamberlain, Ariana Grande, Rosalia, Taylor Swift, Hailey Pham, and Ella Aesthetic. This does not mean these celebrities or influencers personally consider themselves a vanilla girl, however. Vanilla girl aesthetic controversy. Download article. 1. Many criticize the aesthetic for its lack of diversity. When you search the term vanilla girl, most of the resulting images feature thin, blonde, white women. Because of this, critics of the aesthetic argue that it promotes a very narrow beauty standard and seeks to exclude women who do not fit that specific look, especially women of color. 5. Some also believe the name Vanilla Girl itself suggests the aesthetic was designed with white women in mind. 2. Some believe it reinforces gender stereotypes. Because the aesthetic often promotes a particular feminine ideal, critics believe it enforces gender roles. Vanilla girls are often encouraged to embrace softness, simplicity, and nostalgia, all of which could be associated with purity culture and the traditional gender role of women being homemakers. 6. 3. Critics say it promotes consumerism. Although the vanilla girl aesthetic promotes living a simple, basic life, it still often has a materialistic nature. This is because those who want to fit the aesthetic may feel pressured to buy the right clothes, makeup, and lifestyle items to get their desired image. Like many niche aesthetics, this can lead to excessive consumption. 7. 4. Some believe the aesthetic has unattainable standards. Influencers on sites like TikTok and Instagram often post highly curated images of their fashion and lifestyles, which are often unattainable to the average person. Critics of the vanilla girl aesthetic believe young women will see these images and feel inadequate when they cannot replicate the look exactly. 8. How to be a vanilla girl. Download article. 1. Wear vintage and timeless fashion. Vanilla girls strive for a classic, nostalgic aesthetic. To get the look, choose staple pieces like white shirts, simple sweaters, and denim jeans. Flowy dresses are also common, as are floral patterns and delicate fabrics like lace and silk. Vintage and forward/or retro-inspired pieces also fit the look. 9. Don't think you have to buy all new clothes to be a vanilla girl. Start with what you already have and slowly add new pieces to your wardrobe when you need new clothes. If you want affordable options, try finding vintage fashion at your local thrift store. 2. Build your wardrobe around neutral and pastel colors. The vanilla girl aesthetic is characterized by visuals that invoke softness and simplicity, like soft, muted tones. Colors like white, cream, beige, blush pink, and lavender are frequently included in vanilla girl fashion and decor, as they help foster a gentle and calming atmosphere. 10. 3. Go for natural and effortless makeup. When choosing makeup, go for a subtle look that enhances your natural features. Opt for a soft blush, light eyeshadow, and natural-looking lip gloss or lipstick. Avoid dramatic makeup and bright colors, as they don't align with the vanilla girl aesthetic. 11. 4. Keep your hair loose and natural. While you can have any hair type or color while being a vanilla girl, many who follow the aesthetic choose to keep their hair long and wavy. Some even dye their hair blonde to better match the aesthetic's color scheme, though this isn't necessary. The goal is to have a low-maintenance look, so wear your hair however you feel most comfortable. 12. 5. Create a comfortable and clean living space. Some vanilla girls choose to embrace the aesthetic in their home decor as well. To do so, get rid of excess clutter and choose furniture with neutral tones and natural materials, like wood. Decorate your space with cozy accessories, like fairy lights, soft blankets, plants, and vintage decor to create a warm and inviting atmosphere. 13. Don't feel like you have to get a complete home makeover if your living space doesn't match the vanilla girl theme. It's totally okay if you're just interested in vanilla girl fashion or makeup. An easy, affordable way to make your home feel more vanilla girl is to simply light a vanilla candle. 6. Take up cozy, simplistic hobbies. Vanilla girls embrace all things soft and nostalgic, and some choose to adopt a more simplistic lifestyle as well. If you want to do so, try hobbies and activities like reading, journaling, drinking warm tea, and spending time with loved ones. 14. 7. Embrace nature and natural beauty. To further embrace the lifestyle, many vanilla girls enjoy spending time outdoors. Go on a picnic, pick flowers in a field, and admire the natural scenery around you. Don't forget to take pictures so other vanilla girls can enjoy the beauty as well. Similar aesthetics. Download article. 1. Clean girl. The clean girl aesthetic is a popular microtrend that embraces a natural, minimalist approach to makeup, clothing, and hairstyles. The fashion is based around clean lines, simple silhouettes, and neutral colors, while makeup focuses on skincare and achieving a dewy, glowing complexion. 15. Many self-proclaimed clean girls also live a clean lifestyle in which they exercise regularly, practice self-care, and eat nutritious foods. 2. Minimalism. Many popular aesthetics and microtrends can be tied back to minimalism. Minimalism simply refers to a lack of clutter and unnecessary detail, and it applies to many aspects of life, including fashion, beauty, art, and decor. The vanilla girl aesthetic's focus on pastel and neutral colors likely draws inspiration from the minimalist movement. 16. 3. Soft girl. The soft girl aesthetic embraces femininity. While more cutesy than the vanilla girl aesthetic, this look also focuses on pastel colors and soft hobbies like reading or baking. The soft girl aesthetic has a range of inspirations from kawaii clothing to preppy styles. 17. 4. Old money. The old money aesthetic is inspired by the classic fashion of the upper class, particularly that of WASP, white Anglo-Saxon Protestant culture in the United States. The fashion has an understated elegance, with a focus on muted color palettes and tailored silhouettes. 18. 5. Girl next door. While the girl next door archetype is sometimes more tomboyish than the vanilla girl aesthetic, the two still have some overlapping qualities. The girl next door aesthetic often embraces all American gender norms and effortless, simplistic beauty. It often includes timeless fashion and beauty, similar to the vanilla girl trend. 19. Expert Q&A. Ask a question. Submit video tips. If you want to try out the vanilla girl aesthetic, give it a shot. It doesn't matter what you look like. Don't feel like you have to conform to certain beauty standards to do something you enjoy. It's okay to enjoy certain aspects of the vanilla girl aesthetic without considering yourself a vanilla girl. It's also okay to call yourself a vanilla girl if you don't embrace every single aspect of the aesthetic as well. Submit a tip. All tip submissions are carefully reviewed before being published. What does preppy mean today? The new TikTok slang, explained. Download article. Plus, learn how to dress in the new preppy aesthetic. Co-authored by Raven Manyard, BA. Last updated, the 27th of July, 2024. Fact checked. New preppy meaning. How to be preppy. Is preppy an insult? Origins and evolution of preppy. Similar slang terms. Other Gen Alpha aesthetics. Video tips. If you're a millennial or older, you probably think of sweater vests and polo shirts when you hear the term preppy. But if you go on TikTok, you'll be surprised to learn that Gen Alpha has given preppy a whole new meaning. Now, the preppy aesthetic features hot pink clothing, smiley faces, and animal prints. If you want to learn more about the new preppy, keep reading as we teach you what preppy means, how it came to exist, how to be preppy, and other Gen Alpha fashion aesthetics. Preppy slang meaning. According to TikTok and Gen Alpha, preppy is an aesthetic based on bright, feminine fashion. Instead of polos and pleated skirts, the preppy style now focuses on the color pink, smiley faces, ribbons, and trendy, baggy t-shirts. Brands like Lululemon and Lilly Pulitzer are especially popular. What does preppy mean to Gen Alpha? Download article. 1. Preppy refers to brightly colored, girly fashion. Gen Alpha's definition of preppy is vastly different from the original meaning of the term. The preppy aesthetic no longer features sweater vests and pleated skirts. Instead, it emphasizes pink, other bright colors, smiley faces, and girly accessories like bows and ribbons. The style started as a TikTok trend and is very popular with young girls. 1. When you hear preppy, think of brands like Lululemon and Lilly Pulitzer. Preppy can also sometimes be an indication of wealth. While one doesn't have to be rich to be preppy, there is often a connection between the two because so many preppy brands and styles are expensive, especially for children and young teens. 2. Preppy is mostly used as an adjective to describe someone's style. For example, if you see someone wearing a bright pink skirt and carrying a Stanley cup, compliment their style by saying something like, "Wow, you look so preppy. I love your outfit." Or, refer to yourself as preppy, "I'm absolutely obsessed with smiley faces, cowgirl boots, and the color pink. I'm so preppy." While the new preppy aesthetic is generally targeted at preteen girls, preppy can also refer to boys who use expensive hygiene products or put effort into their appearance. The masculine side of the preppy aesthetic is less fashion-focused than the feminine side. For example, my brother spends hours on his skincare routine. He's so preppy. That being said, it's perfectly fine for a boy to dress according to the preppy aesthetic if he wants to. But generally, clothing brands orient preppy clothing toward tween girls more than they do toward boys. How to wear the preppy aesthetic. Download article. 1. Wear bright colors and patterns. One of the key factors in achieving the new preppy aesthetic is dressing in vibrant colors, like hot pink and cyan. Bold patterns are also popular, like cheetah and leopard print and feminine florals. Prints featuring smiley faces, cowboy hats, hearts, and lightning bolts also play a large role in the preppy look. 2. Brand logos like Louis Vuitton, Chanel, and Prada are also popular, but don't feel like you have to buy these products, especially if they are out of your price range. 2. Choose comfortable but feminine outfits. A lot of preppy fashion combines traditionally girly clothing with trendy athleisure wear. Opt for ruffled skirts in pastel colors, animal print, or floral print, and shirts with bishop sleeves or lettuce edges for a more feminine look. Or, go for a cami crop top, or baggy t-shirt with bike shorts, yoga pants, or sweatpants for a casual preppy style. 3. As for shoes, Nike Air Forces, Birkenstocks, and cowboy boots are very popular. 3. Wear and carry trendy accessories. While you can be preppy without keeping up with all the latest trends, a lot of popular trends happen to fall under the preppy aesthetic. For example, Stanley Cups are trendy in general, and they are very popular with those who enjoy the preppy aesthetic. Charm bracelets and friendship bracelets, evil eye anklets, and heart-shaped sunglasses are also really trendy. 4. Craft a skincare routine that works for you. While many members of Gen Alpha are too young to wear a full face of makeup, a lot of people with the preppy aesthetic are obsessed with skincare, particularly from brands like Drunk Elephant. 5. Don't feel like you have to go buy a ton of skincare products, but consider using one or two products that promote healthy skin, like a cleanser and a moisturizer. 5. Listen to pop music. You can still be preppy without listening to pop music, but many preppy people enjoy trendy songs that are often played in TikTok videos. Think artists like Olivia Rodrigo, Taylor Swift, Dua Lipa, and The Weeknd. 6. Have an upbeat, positive attitude. Living a preppy lifestyle is more than just wearing the right clothes. Try to be as kind and friendly as possible. Go out and meet new people and spend plenty of time with your friends by going to the beach or mall or just hanging out at your house. Don't forget to post your adventures on TikTok. 7. Is preppy an insult? Download article. 1. Preppy can be a compliment or an insult. It all depends on if you, or the person calling you preppy, like the aesthetic or not. If you're a fan of bright colors and enjoy the preppy trend, the word has positive associations. If you don't like the aesthetic, calling someone preppy or being called preppy would be considered an insult. For example, Some people say those who dress preppy only care about clothing and trends that are popular on TikTok rather than finding their own style. If one of these people calls something preppy, they probably mean it negatively. On the other hand, if a girl who loves pink and smiley faces calls your shirt preppy, she probably likes it. Historically, the word preppy has often had negative connotations, as many people think those who have a preppy style are stuck up. Remember, don't judge a book by its cover. Get to know someone before assuming what they're like, simply based on how they dress. The old preppy meaning and evolution. Download article. 1. 1. Preppy was originally associated with prep school fashion. The old preppy describes people who attended prep schools or look and behave like prep school students or graduates. The style, which often featured items like polo shirts and sweater vests, was viewed as a status symbol for the wealthy. 8. This meaning of the term has been around since the early 1900s and has historically been tied to elite, Ivy League preparatory schools. While the exact fashion changed over the decades, the overall understanding of the word preppy largely remained the same until recent years. In fact, this definition of preppy is still the meaning accepted by the dictionary and by millennials, elder Gen Zers, and other older generations. 2. 2. The new preppy began as a TikTok trend. Like many Gen Z and Gen Alpha fashion trends, the new preppy aesthetic seems to have originated on TikTok. Content creators began posting videos wearing brightly colored fashion from brands like Lululemon and sporting the popular Stanley Cup, both of which have become staples in the preppy aesthetic. Teen and preteen girls then quickly adopted the style for themselves. Some brands are even dedicated specifically to the new preppy style, like Dear Hannah Prep, a Texas boutique for girls that went viral on TikTok for their trendy, colorful fashion. It's possible the new version of preppy is called such because it still has ties to wealth. Many trendy styles and products promoted on TikTok can be expensive, and being able to participate in all the trends may be a sign that someone has a wealthy background. This isn't always the case, however. 3. 3. Videos from older generations caused the trend to go viral. Surprisingly, it wasn't Gen Alpha that made the new version of preppy so well known, it was their parents. Many parents and older siblings of Gen Alpha started posting TikTok videos where they try to guess what different Gen Alpha slang terms mean. Millennials and other older generations were shocked to learn the definition of preppy had changed, leading to many viral videos and conversations about the new aesthetic. 9. Similar slang terms. Download article. 1. Basic in slang, basic means something is boring, mainstream, or unoriginal. Some members of Gen Alpha think the preppy aesthetic is the equivalent of basic, although the term basic is used more by millennials and some Gen Z. 10. For example, the stereotype of a basic girl is someone who wears Uggs, drinks pumpkin spice lattes, and takes lots of selfies. These things are all very mainstream, so people who enjoy them are sometimes called basic because other people think they are unoriginal. 2. Choogy choogy refers to things that are outdated, unfashionable, or uncool. It's the opposite of trendy and can also refer to something or someone who is trying too hard to be trendy or cool. Chuji is mostly when discussing fashion or aesthetics. 11. For example, many members of Gen Alpha think millennial fashion trends like side bangs and skinny jeans are unfashionable. They might say the style is chuji. 3. Waspy. Waspy refers to anything relating to WASPs, white Anglo-Saxon Protestants, which is a term used to describe the wealthy, privileged upper class of America. These people are typically viewed as snobby, and they often dress in traditional preppy, or old money, clothing. Therefore, Gen Alpha may refer to those clothing aesthetics as waspy. 12. For example, if someone was wearing tailored trousers, a polo shirt, and a sweater vest, they might look waspy. 4. Fire is a slang term used to describe something that is exciting, amazing, or really popular. If someone calls something fire, it means they really like it. Fire can be used for all kinds of things, including fashion, songs, video games, and anything else Gen Alpha enjoys. 13. For example, if someone likes your outfit, they might say, "Wow, you look so preppy today. Your outfit is fire." 5. Girly pop. Girly pop is a term of endearment often used for girls and women who are feminine, relatable, and bubbly. Many preppy girls may also be girly pop. It is also used within the LGBTQ+ community to refer to a gay person. 14. For example, you might say, "You look so cute today, girly pop." Or, "That girl is always so nice to everyone. She's so girly pop." Other Gen Alpha aesthetics. Download article. 1. Coquette. Originally inspired by the controversial novel Lolita, the coquette aesthetic focuses on hyperfeminine fashion that incorporates elements of youth and girlhood. Those with this aesthetic often wear pink and pastels, lace, florals, pearls, and bows. 15. This trend has sparked controversy due to its association with Lolita and the sexualization of young girls. As younger generations, like Gen Alpha, have adopted the style, however, it has become notably less sexual and more focused on femininity. 2. Cottagecore. Also popular with Gen Z, the cottagecore aesthetic is inspired by simple living and the romanticization of agricultural life. Those with this aesthetic often enjoy peaceful hobbies like baking and crafts. The fashion often includes earthy, natural colors, florals, long skirts and dresses, and overalls. 16. 3. Clean girl. The clean girl aesthetic is a microtrend that focuses on a minimalist approach to fashion and beauty. It emphasizes natural beauty, skincare, and healthy lifestyles. Those with this aesthetic tend to wear neutral colors, clean lines, and simple silhouettes, including items like crisp white blouses, high-waisted trousers, and high-quality denim. 17. 4. Vanilla girl. Similar to the clean girl aesthetic, the vanilla girl style focuses on simplicity, femininity, and nostalgia. Those with this aesthetic often wear neutral and pastel colors, natural makeup, and retro-inspired clothing. 18. 5. Old money. The old money aesthetic is a modern fashion trend that is most closely related to the original meaning of preppy. Those with this aesthetic seek a wealthy, classic style and often wear tailored clothing like blazers, sweaters, and tweed. 19. Expert Q&A. Ask a question. Submit. Video. Tips. Don't feel like you have to go buy every new trend to be preppy. Try to build your look around items you already have in your closet, and only buy new items if you really, really like them. Remember, trends change quickly, so if you only buy it because it's popular, you may never wear it. Does Netflix have a student discount? How to save on streaming as a student? Download article. Tips to save money on Netflix and get discounts on other platforms. Co-authored by Glenn Cario. Last updated, the 21st of July, 2024. Fact checked. Does Netflix have a student discount? Saving money on a Netflix account. Netflix subscription pricing. Streaming platforms with student discounts. Free streaming services. Are you a college student trying to save money, but still want plenty of movies and shows to watch when you're bored? We can help. Netflix doesn't offer a student discount anymore, or a free trial period, but that doesn't mean you can't save money in other ways. In this guide, we'll show you how to save money on a Netflix account, plus outline several Netflix alternatives with student discounts, and even a few services that are totally free. Read on to learn more. Netflix student discounts, what to know. Netflix doesn't offer a student discount subscription plan, but you can share an account with other students using the same internet connection or join your family's plan to get Netflix for less money, or for free. You can also get student discounts from Hulu, Amazon Prime, Max, and more. Does Netflix have a student discount? Download article. 1. Netflix doesn't offer student discounts, but there are other ways to save. If you're a student wondering if you can get a sweet discount on a Netflix subscription, unfortunately, there aren't any straightforward discounts available. Both Netflix and Disney and have stopped offering student discounts on subscriptions, and Netflix no longer offers a free trial period, either. However, if you're dead set on getting a Netflix subscription, there are a couple of ways to do it and still save some money. Check out the tips below. There are also other streaming services that do offer student discounts, so if you don't mind missing out on Netflix original content, you could sign up for a different service instead. How to save money on a Netflix account. Download article. 1. Ask a parent or friend if you can have a profile on their account. If someone close to you, a parent or good friend, already has an account and doesn't mind sharing, the easiest way to use Netflix as a student is to simply make a profile on their account. However, Netflix puts limits on account sharing. You'll only be able to do it if you use the same internet connection. 1. According to Netflix's website, Netflix accounts are meant to be shared by people in one household. So, you can use your parents' account if you live with them, or a friend's if you live in the same dorm. 2. Subscribe to Netflix with other students and split the cost. If you're living in a dorm with other students who want to stream Netflix too, you could all chip in some money and make profiles on a Netflix account shared between each of you. Keep in mind that each subscription tier has a limit on the number of devices you can stream from at the same time, though. 2. For example, if you share a premium account with other students, you can Stream Netflix from up to 4 devices at once. If you share a standard account, that limit drops to 2 devices at once. That still means if you and 3 other students get a premium subscription, you can pay about $5.75/month for it instead of $22.99, assuming you split the cost evenly 4 ways. 3. Get a Netflix subscription for a limited time. If there's something specific you want to watch on Netflix and you don't mind cancelling your subscription after finishing it, you could always just pay full price on a subscription for a short time. While it's not a discount, you at least wouldn't have to keep paying a monthly fee this way. For example, you could subscribe to Netflix for a month and try to watch all the content exclusive to Netflix that you want, then cancel before your subscription renews the next month. Alternatively, some credit cards also let you earn rewards or points on streaming services. If you want to start building your credit score, or you've already started, you could look into a card with streaming benefits. How much do Netflix subscriptions cost? Download article. 1. Netflix subscriptions cost a minimum of $6.99/month as of 2024. Currently, there are 3 different tiers of Netflix subscription: standard with ads, standard, and premium. Both standard subscriptions let you stream and download content on up to 2 devices at 1080p resolution, while a premium subscription lets you stream on 4 devices, download content on 6, and stream at 4K resolution. 3. Standard with ads, $6.99/month. Standard, $15.49/month. Premium, $22.99/month. Other streaming services with student discounts. Download article. 1. Amazon Prime. Amazon Prime offers a student subscription that includes free Prime shipping and access to Amazon Prime's movies, TV shows, Amazon Prime Music, its music streaming service, and a number of other deals for college students. Students can enjoy this deal for up to 4 years, which includes a 6-month free trial, after which the subscription costs $69/year, half the normal price. 4. Pros: you get a lengthy trial period, access to Prime Originals, and other deals, including a free Grubhub trial. Cons: you'll need a .edu email to get this discount, and it can take a few days for Amazon to verify your email. This discount will also end on your graduation date, or after 4 years, whichever comes first. 2. Hulu. Hulu has a couple of different discounts available for students. For Hulu alone, you can get an ad-supported plan for 75% off the original price, or $1.99/month. On the other hand, if you're a Spotify user, you can sign up for Spotify student discount instead and get Hulu bundled for free. Spotify's current discount includes 1 month free, then charges $5.99/month after that. 5. Pros: both options last for as long as you're a college student, and with the bundle, you can get Spotify for half the normal price. You can also access Hulu's original shows and movies. Cons: both options are for an ad-supported subscription to Hulu only, so you'll have to get an account with ads. You also can't get this discount with Hulu's live TV. 3 Paramount and students get 25% off their subscription with Paramount and S student plan. Meaning it'll cost you $4.50/month. This subscription is only available with limited ads. And like many other streaming services on this list, uses Share ID to verify your identity. And enrollment in a higher education institution before giving you the discount. 6. Pros: you'll get Paramount and original content, plus live CBS TV and on-demand content. It's also cheaper than some other streaming platforms. Cons: Paramount and S catalog of content is more limited than Netflix or Hulu, and you have to watch with ads on the student plan. 4. Peacock's student discount includes 12 months of discounted premium membership. While a premium subscription normally costs $5.99/month, students can subscribe to Peacock for $1.99/month instead. You can also choose whether you want to pay for the whole year or by month, the price is the same either way. 7. Pros: it's a cheap subscription and a solid discount. Cons: it only lasts for a year, even if you're still a student. 5. Max: HBO's Max streaming platform offers a 50% discount for students when you sign up and get verified as a student enrolled at an educational institution, which Max does. Through Unities, you can get an ad-supported Max plan for $4.99/month. You can use this deal as long as you're a student, as Max just requires you to verify your status again every 12 months. 8. Pros: you get access to all HBO original shows, movies, and other content. Cons: you can only get this deal with a plan that includes ads. 6. YouTube Premium's student plan removes ads from YouTube videos and lets you access original shows and movies, plus YouTube Music, its music streaming service. The student plan offers a 60% discount off the regular price of the subscription, a 1 month free trial, then $7.99/month, although this deal requires a yearly verification of enrollment as a student. 9. Pros: you'll get to watch YouTube originals and all videos ad-free. Cons: there's less original content on YouTube compared to other services. There's also a family plan for YouTube Premium that costs $22.99/month. If your parents or siblings plan to get a subscription, you could use theirs with a family plan instead. Free streaming alternatives to Netflix. Download article. 1. Tubi, Crackle, and Fandango at Home all let you stream content for free. Don't want to pay for a streaming subscription at all, or want a backup to your streaming subscription that doesn't cost extra? We've got you. A few streaming options won't charge you a cent, or even force you to make an account, in some cases. Try Tubi TV, Sony Crackle, Fandango at Home, Pluto TV, or Amazon's Freevee app to stream for free. Keep in mind that many of these platforms do have ads, since they're free. Otherwise,